Ebiru was set to appear in the dock to answer charges relating to his confession that he paid 100 million shillings with the National Standards Council members in order to retain his job. However, Ebiru did not show up in the dock and he remained in court custody.
He was brought here, more information were coming, so he was taken back for further interrogation.
Prosecution, led by Rogers Chinobe, sought criminal summons after court heard that he could not appear in the dock because he was still being interrogated, asking the judge to give him another date to be brought in court.
He's expected to appear in court on the 8th of August, but he's expected to be here on the 4th of August. Thereafter, we shall proceed with the investigations and in case of any other clarification, and then we shall be able to see how to proceed thereafter.
As a result, the chief magistrate issued the criminal summons to Ebiru, who is expected to appear before court on 8th August 2023. However, Ebiru was taken out of court custody to the IGG spokesperson, Ali Munira, who explained the charges he committed. According to Munira, the case is still under investigation and Ebiru is expected to appear before the IGG on 4th August 2023.
Along the way, we have received some information which required him to come back for further interrogation, and therefore we are not able to proceed with the court matter. And we are going for the interrogation. So he has officially received what we call the IG bond. And he has presented two sureties. And so he has been given IG bond and is set to appear on the 4th of August.
Last week, the Uganda National Bureau of Standards Executive Director, David Livingstone Ebiru, confessed to bribing the entity's body with 100 million shillings to prevent the termination of his contract of service. He made the revelation while appearing before COSASE, which is scrutinizing the Auditor General's report for the financial year 2021-2022 in relation to UNBS.
By the chair, that I must do the needful to cool down what is going on.
And you gave them 100 million shillings?
Yes, sir.
Where did you get the 100 million shillings from?
I borrowed the money.
So this was personal money?
Yes, sir.
And you handed it over to who?
Through the representative of the chairman, one of the board members here,
Mr. Omar.
He came to my office and picked it from my office.
Was it cash? It was in what?
Cash.
Cash. In a bag? In what exactly?
In a bag.
The bureau's lawyer was happy that his client was released on bond.
It's free. It's all police
law. Report compiled by Judith Nalugwa for the news.